Hi, my name is Matt Ruark. I'm an extension soil scientist with the University of Wisconsin Extension. Today we're going to talk about interseeding cover crops into corn. So cover crops are a great management tool for farmers that are interested in improving the soil condition, reducing erosion, and trapping excess nitrate. However, the challenge for farmers in Wisconsin is getting cover crops planted in corn production systems. So there's not enough growing season left over at the end of the year for a successful cover crop establishment if you're going to plant after corn harvest. A potential management practice that may work and may be beneficial is planting or interseeding the cover crops into corn in the mid-vegetative growth stage. So we're here at the Arlington Research Station to show off some of the research we've done with planting red clover, rye, radish, and an OP mixture, and to evaluate how well they grow and establish when interseeded.
This trial was established in early May of 2015 with the intent of harvesting grain yield off of the corn. The corn was managed for weeds with a standard application of glyphosate prior to cover crop establishment. The cover crops were established at V5 corn, and we utilized a modified no-till drill. This drill was modified so that four rows were taken off of the drill so that we could drive down through the corn rows without damaging the corn and establishing our cover crops with good soil to seed contact with the use of the drill. The cover crops that we utilized include radish, red clover, cereal rye, and a 30% peas to 70% oats mixture, and the oats and the peas were mixed together prior to planting. These cover crops were established utilizing university recommended seeding rates and depths. The corn and the cover crops were visually assessed throughout the growing season to see if there was any stress from the cover crops and the corn canopy. Neither was shown throughout the 2014 and 2015 growing seasons. This corn will be harvested in a few weeks for grain and yield measurements will be taken. The cover crops will be assessed for biomass accumulation at the end of the growing season, as well as in the spring, we will evaluate to see if the rye has survived winter. In 2014, we did the same trial and we looked at corn yield and biomass of the cover crop again. There was no significant difference in grain yield between any of the cover crop treatments and our non-treated control that did not have a cover crop. The cover crop biomass accumulation looked really good in the fall with strong measurements on tillage radish and red clover. The red clover and cereal rye were the only cover crops that survived winter. However, cereal rye was the only cover crop that needed to be terminated in the spring at time of planting.
So what have we learned so far? Well, we've learned that the cover crops did establish well. Interseeding the cover crops at the V5 growth stage seemed to work well for the radish, as well as the clover and the rye. Well, what about the short-term benefits that also occur? Future research will focus on evaluating the nitrogen credit associated with planting the clovers and the long-term benefits in soil improvement by planting the radish and the rye, as well as other cover crops. For more information, check out the Integrated Pest and Crop Management website, as well as the Soils Extension website in the Department of Soil Science.